Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see about accumulation property. So accumulation is property is a bit confusing, guys. I even get confused a lot in this property. So the main formula will be like this. If x1 of n, that is nothing but z transform of f, x1 of n is x of z, then z transform of sigma k equal to minus infinity x of k should be 1 by 1 minus z to the power of minus 1 into x of z. So it seems to be really simple and easy. Okay, so now let us go through the proof. So we know that z of x1 of n is equal to sigma n equal to minus infinity x1 of n into z to the power of minus n. Let x1 of n is equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity x1 of k. So z is nothing but sigma n equal to minus infinity x of k. Right? Yep, that's true. Okay, just give me a second. Okay, fine. So sigma n equal to minus infinity, sigma n k equal to minus infinity x of k, z to the power of minus n. Just substituted all the values that we have, guys. So here we'll be assuming that n minus k is equal to r is the single equation. So we'll be finding n. What is n? Is equal to k plus r, and what is k? K is nothing but n minus r. Okay. So we'll be solving, substituting all these values in this to make the equations a bit simple. So it became sigma minus infinity to infinity sigma r equal to infinity to 0. As when we convert the k and r relation is completely negative, right? So this, if this is positive, this will be negative. So that's the reason why I have just converted it in the opposite sign. So it became infinity to 0, x of k, z to the power of minus k, x power minus r. So I'll be pushing this to the outside and this to the outside, so that it will be really easy for us, as it is in terms of r and this is also in terms of r. Fine. So sigma r equal to 0 to infinity z to the power of r. I think everyone have a small idea about this formula, which I have discussed previously. X to the power of minus n. Sorry, okay. Z to the power of minus n is nothing but 1 by 1 minus z. This is the formula, guys. Okay. Fine. Okay, guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So this is the formula which we'll be substituting. We get 1 by 1 minus z inverse. So this whole part is nothing but x of z. The Fourier transform of x of z is this x of k is this formula. So we'll be assuming the result as x of z. So this is what the accumulation property says. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through convolution property, conjugation. Sorry, it's conjugation property, guys. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.